Very good morning to one and all. I am Dr. Jasmeer Kaur Randhawa from Government College of Engineering, Nagpur. I am presenting my work on a review work on conduction of composite solid electrolytes. The composite electrolytes I mean here are the crystal composites in which some micron size inert particles like alumina are dispersed in ionic conductors, and it has been observed that the conductivity of this material increases linearly for the dispersoid concentration less than 40 mole percent, and the conductivity enhancement is of the order of 50 times at room temperature. Maximum conductivity enhancement of the order of two orders of magnitude has been observed for certain materials. Since Liang reported it in 1973, many such dispersoids have been tried for different types of solid electrolytes. The characteristics of composite electrolytes are that we observe maximum enhancement in conductivity at lower temperatures, whereas at high temperatures the conductivity attains the value which are same to the pure system. And the composite electrolyte, it's not that always the conductivity is seen increasing. In some materials the conductivity is also seen decreasing. In certain materials, when they are under pressurized condition, the conductivity enhancement is seen in pure phase as well as in composite. But after annealing, it has been observed that pure phase loses the enhancement in conduction, whereas in composite the enhancement is retained. So the composites are such that we can modify their properties which are desired for us. And almost all insoluble particles are effective. Different types of particles have been tried and all have been observed to be effective. Recently it has been reported that there is a small very thin layer of the order of 10 to 15 nanometer is seen at the interface from the NMR data, and based on that the conduction mechanism is very successfully explained. The classical model for conductivity enhancement is such that it will add the conductivities of the two phases that are there, and it has miserably failed in the in explaining the conduction enhancement. The first model that is given is the classical doping theory, in which it has been suggested that whatever dopant we are using, like here if we are using Al2O3, then the Al2O3 is getting dissolved into its components Al and O3 with certain vacancies generated. And if we go for this model, then small percentage of dopant is sufficient to give us two orders of magnitude enhancement in conductivity. But here for the composite systems we are observing that we need up to 20 to 40% of mole percent of the dopant. So classical theory is again not a successful theory, but it was the first theory that has been thought of. The Wagner's model on semiconductors has been given, which is based on the inclusion of another phase. Here the another phase that has been considered is a metal which is inserted in the metal oxide system, and the defect creation around the metal particle, or the space charge creation around the metal particle, has been worked out to explain the conduction enhancement. The charge density has been given by an expression N2 exponential of E phi by kT. Here phi is the solution of this differential equation, and the conductivity enhancement is given in terms of the volume fraction of the dispersoid and the radius of the dispersoid particle. So this particular enhancement given by Wagner was tested by Zhou for the alumina particle of varying size and the volume fraction has been kept constant, the theoretical prediction for 10 volume percent of alumina dispersoid with the particle size 0.06 micron and 0.3 micron, the conductivity enhancement was expected to be 23, but the experimental result was found to be only 5 times enhancement has been observed. So the space charge model, which is applicable for the semiconductors, is not applicable for the composite electrolytes that are under consideration. Now again, the space charge model based on the space charge model, which is based on the which is based on the consideration that the types of defects are being generated at the interface, and these defects are giving us the space charge potential phi, which is giving us the enhancement in conduction. So that particular vacancy concentration and the interstitial defect concentration at the interface of the host matrix and the dispersoid. Here it is assumed that the dispersoid is embedded in the host matrix, and the separation between the two centers of the dispersoid are of the order of twice R. This particular model is supposed to be better one, because it is giving us the depth lambda for the space charge density, which is which is developing at the interface of the dispersoid and the host system. Based on this, when the enhancement of conductivity has been worked out, because Liang's data was not available for the varying particle size, the volume fraction has been considered here. The equation has been modified to consider the volume fraction, and it has been observed that the space charge generated in the form of vacancy and Frenkel defects at the interface is giving us the linear relation at low concentrations, and the conductivity enhancement at low temperatures are being successfully explained, whereas at high concentration there is deviation. The decrease in conductivity at high concentration is due to the presence of more number of second phase, which is a non-conducting second phase. The next model which has been worked out was related to the defect concentration enhancement not occurring by the space charge layer, but by the formation of amorphous phase at the interface of the host system and the dispersoid. The amorphous phase, as I have already explained in the characteristics, that there is an amorphous phase observed for the copper chloride alumina system through the NMR study. So Jiang and Wagner has worked on the defect chemistry of this two phase system, and this model gives us the enhancement of defects at the interface and the formation of some new very thin layer at the interface. So this model gives us the defect formation at the interface and how these defects at the interface are connected, that are being done in the form of simulations. The title is that percolation theory, that all these highly conducting thin layers of amorphous nature are connected through the system, and they are giving us the linking path to give us conduction mechanisms. The random resistor model has been used with Monte Carlo simulation, and the conductivity data has been fitted with various parameters. This model could explain the conductivity enhancement data, but this model is not giving us any relation between the physical parameters of the component species, that is the host system and the dispersoid. And based on those parameters, the magnitude of enhancement is not being explained through this concept. And therefore, the most successful model which is available is the Myers theory, which is based on the surface interaction. Myers theory has demonstrated that in this kind of heterogeneously doped system, the interface interaction causes deviation from the local electrical neutrality, which are responsible for the characteristic properties. So the space charge concept is being used here, but the different types of possible interactions that are thought of are the underlying structure is maintained in this consideration, and all the variation is being assumed, that is assumed at the interface only. The materials at the interface, the materials parameters are changing smoothly as it is seen in the space charge layer lambda. The impurities, again the Frenkel and Schottky types of defects that are injected at the interface, and this thin layer is defined by is being formed due to the thermodynamic reasons. So these the distinction between the pathways which are responsible for the conduction are being worked out and it has been considered that at the interface there is a defect formation, and these defect formation which are seen in the form of crosses here, they are different types. There can be conduction through the bulk, there can be conduction through the dispersoid, there can be conduction through the interface. And to distinguish between all these three types of conduction, the impedance plots, which are more or less separate, gives us the frequency data or the time domain data about the conduction process, and we can distinguish that yes, these conductions are occurring at the grain boundaries perpendicular to the interface, which are the low frequency data. Then at high frequency data of the impedance plot, we get the conduction due to the bulk, which we call as RB, R infinity, and along the parallel to the motion of ions parallel to the grain boundaries. So we ourselves have studied most of our composite electrolyte systems using this particular model, and we have been very successfully able to work out the type of defects that are being generated at the interface, and this I think is the most successful model we have today. Thank you very much for giving me this opportunity.